Hi there, Ms. Barber here. This lesson is titled Truth Tables for the Conditional and Biconditional. The author of your textbook received mail with the following claim. If your Super Million Dollar Prize entry number matches the winning pre-selected number, and if you return the number before the deadline stated below, you will win $1 million. Should he obediently return the number before the deadline, or trash the whole thing? In this lesson, we will learn the logic used to analyze claims like these. You will be equipped to determine under what conditions such claims are true, or whether such claims are true at all ever. To begin, we will have new truth table definitions. The first definition is a conditional. A conditional has the form if, then. So we begin with a truth table, two columns, one P, one Q, to ensure that you get every variation of true and false. Under P, you will write T, T, F, F, and for Q, under it, you'll write T, F, T, F. P, right arrow, Q, is read if P, then Q. It is also read P implies Q, and the following are the definitions. Truth implies true, by definition is true. True implies false, by definition is false. False implies true, by definition is true. And false implies false, by definition is
true.
Have this memorized by heart. Now let's look at an example to illustrate. Example, consider the statement, if you get an A on the final, then you will pass the course. Under what condition or conditions would the person who made the statement be considered dishonest? So we're going to look at every possible variation. You made an F on the final and failed the course. Well, that would mean false implies false because you didn't make an A on the final and you didn't pass the course. But you're not going to be surprised because you didn't meet the criteria. How about you made an F on the final exam and passed the course? Let's see, making an F on the final exam means you didn't make an A, so that's a false, but you still passed the class. So false implies true. Let's think about this. If you failed the final exam and you still passed the course, are you kind of cool with that? That gives us a nice return. That's a true. How about you made an A on the final exam and passed the course? You met the requirement and you got the result you were promised. That is, truth implies truth, and we're cool with that as well. However, what if you made an A on the final exam and still failed the course? You met the requirement, so you met the true, but the result was false. This is where you get the false. I didn't know how to do an X, so I did an upside down smile. Next truth table definition is the biconditional, if and only if statements. Again, we start the truth table with P and Q. Under P is T, T, F, F, and under Q is T, F, T, F. P, double-sided arrow, Q is read P, if and only if, Q. By definition, for the first column, T, if and only if, T is true. By definition, T, if and only if, F is false. By definition, F, if and only if, T is also false. And by definition, F, if and only if F, is true. Memorize this as well. Example, construct a truth table for the compound statement P implies Q and Q implies P. Let's begin with P implies Q. That's the definition we just learned. So the definition tells us truth implies truth is true. True implies false is false. False implies true is actually true. And false implies false is also true. Now, let's construct the truth table portion for Q implies P. We're going from the right to the left, looking at the first two columns. Truth implies truth. That's true. How about false implies true? That's actually true. Truth implies false. That is false. And false implies false is true. Now we're going to look at the compound statement of P implies Q and Q implies P. When we are looking at a conjunction, all parts have to be true in order for that compound statement to be true. Let's begin. True and true is true. False and true is false. True and false is also false. And true is true. I would like to compare this to the truth values for the biconditional connective P if and only if Q. By definition, P if and only if Q, the truth values are true, false, false, true. Let's observe that P implies Q and Q implies P has the same truth values as the definition of P if and only if Q. The biconditional connective P if and only if Q is equivalent to the conjunction of the two conditional statements P implies Q and Q implies P. Let's get some more definitions out of the way. A self-contradiction is a compound statement that is always false. A tautology is a compound statement that is always true. And then we'll put some things together for the third definition. A conditional statement that is a tautology is called an implication. Example, construct a truth table for the compound statement P and Q implies not P or Q. Let's begin with the conjunction P and Q. On the truth table, you have P, and in the rows that follow, it's T, T, F, F. To the immediate right, we have Q, and the rows that follow, T, F, T, F. For the conjunction, that's for and, all parts must be true in order for that connection to be true. So true and true is true. And the remaining ones are all false. True and false is false. False and true is false. False and false is false. Now, let's find the negation of P. That means we want the opposite truth value. For P, we had T, T, F, F. The opposite truth values would be F, F, T, T. Now, let's find the disjunction, not P or Q. When you're using the disjunction, all you need is one part to be true in order for that entire connected statement to be true. So we'll have false or true, that's true. False or false, that's false. True or true is true. And true or false is also true. Now we can set up the implication. P and Q implies not P or Q. We are using the if-then statement. So we will have truth implies truth. That's true. False implies false. That's also true. False implies true is true. And false implies true is true. Notice that every truth value in the last column is true. This compound statement is a tautology, and since it is also a conditional statement, meaning that it's an if-then statement, it is also an implication. Example, construct a truth table for the compound statement P and in parentheses Q and not P. We'll begin this by computing the negation of P. This truth table below P, we have true, true, false, false. And below Q, you have true, false, true, false. The negation of P, we just want the opposite truth values. So you will have false, false, true, true. Now let's put it together with Q. That is Q and not P. And is a conjunction, which means all components must be true in order for that connected statement to be true. We are looking at false and true. That's false. False and false is also false. True and true is true. And true and false is false. Now let's put this together with the P and. So P and in parentheses, Q and not P. We'll begin. True and false, that's false. True and false, that's also false. False and true is false, and false and false is also false. This compound statement is a self-contradiction. Example. Refer to the following statement to answer the questions that follow. The statement, if you buy my product at full price and you don't like it, then I will refund all of your money. Part A, assign simple statements to P, Q, and R, all in the affirmative, and write symbolically. Let P be the statement, you buy my product at full price. Now the instructions say all in the affirmative, and so the second part where it says you don't like it, in the affirmative, I will let Q be, you like it. And finally, R is I will refund all of your money. Let's write this symbolically. P and not Q implies R. Part B, construct a truth table that represents the original statement and symbolically that was P and not Q in parentheses implies R. You have a truth table with three statements. Under P, you have four T's, true, 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 followed by false, 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 false. Under Q, it's in groups of two, true, true, false, false, true, true, false, false. And then the rows below R alternate true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. Every possible combination of true and false for each of the three statements. Let's begin with negating the Q. We want the opposite truth values. The opposite of true is false. The opposite of true is false. The opposite of false is true. Opposite of false is true. Opposite of true is false. Opposite of true is false. And then finally, opposites of false twice, that would be true and true. Now let's look at the conjunction P and not Q. Remember with and, which is a conjunction, all parts must be true in order for that compound statement to be true. So we're going to have true and false, that's false. True and false, that's false. True and true is true though. True and true is also true. False and false, false. We got false and false again, which is also false. False and true, that's false. False and true, that's also false. Now let's do the truth value for the conditional if then. If P and not Q, then R. Applying the definition, false implies true is true. False implies false, that's also true. True implies true, that's true. True implies false, that's false. And then false implies true is true. False implies false is true. False implies true is true. And false implies false, that's true. So the last column we have TTT. F, T, 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 T. Only one instance in which the conditional is false. Question: list all condition or conditions that would make the statement false. It happens only one time, and that's if you paid full price for the product and did not like it and did not get a full refund. Otherwise, every possible combination here, the final column is true. Example: refer to the following statement to answer the questions that follow. If I tell you there will be a quiz, then there will be a quiz. Assign simple statements to P and Q. I'll let P be "I tell you there will be a quiz," so that would be the if. And the Q would be "then there is a quiz." Write the statement symbolically. That's just P implies Q. If I tell you there's going to be a quiz, there will be a quiz. Construct a truth table that corresponds to the if-then statement, P implies Q. Truth implies true, that's true. True implies false, that is false. But false implies true, that's true. And false implies false, that's also true. Part D. Write symbolically the statement that corresponds to the statement, if there is no quiz, then I did not tell you there would be a quiz. We'll use the same P and Q as we used previously. Then in this case, this would be not Q implies not P. Part E. Construct a truth table that corresponds to the statement. We have a truth table platform with P and Q. Under P is T, T, F, F. Under Q is T, F, T, F. Let's begin by negating Q. So the negation of true is false. The negation of false is true. The negation of true is false. The negation of false is true. Now let's negate P. We negate true, true, false, false. So the negation would be false, false, true, true. Let's get the truth values for the conditional. Not Q implies not P. We've got false implies false, that's true. True implies false, that's false. False implies true is true. True implies true is also true. Now let's look at the truth values for P implies Q. Notice that it has the same truth value as not Q implies not P. We conclude that these two statements are logically equivalent, and we will soon learn that one is called the contrapositive of the other.